As he waits for the men's free skate tomorrow night, Canadian champion Elvis Stoico is in second place. From France, Philippe Candeloro is currently in third. Scott Hamilton will preview the men's final when we come back.
One Olympic champion, another Olympic champion, and a four-time world champion. In the men's technical program, the expectations were high, but the reality was somewhat different.
Go out yonder, peace in the valley. Come downtown, have to rumble in the alley.
Was what people expected. Three of the most experienced and successful men in the history of figure skating being 1, 2, and 3, and this is where it's at. Who would have figured 8th, 9th, and 12th? For Brian Boitano, he came to Norway to repeat the glory of 1988, but that dream ended in less than a second. Just a different Brian Boitano showed up, a man with very little chance at a medal, but a man who could perform the triple axel that betrayed him the night before.
I need to reevaluate. I need to just find what's real, you know. I'm not going to skate tomorrow night to in hopes of pulling up from 8th to 1st. That's not the right reason, and that's not the reason that I came back. I need to just make myself happy.
The defending Olympic gold medalist seemed lost and without hope in practice today. His dream of a third Olympic medal is all but over. He apologized to the world after a short program in Albertville. Last night, Kurt Browning's Olympic nightmare continued. Unbelievable.
It happened, it's over, and my Olympic hopes are gone.
Today, Kurt Browning climbed back on that Olympic ice that treated him so unfairly the night before, practicing the long program he intended to win the gold medal with. Now he's performing this program for pride.
One of the aspects of figure skating that makes it so popular is that life imitates art. And that was going to be the case at this year's Olympic Games. Kurt Browning, last year's world champion, is going to once again skate to the music of Casablanca to try to win another gold medal, this time at the Olympic Games. But with a disastrous technical program, that won't be the case. Now we're going to see movies like Dragon, the Bruce Lee story as personified by Elvis Stoico, West Side Story, American champion Scott Davis, or The Wild Man from France, Philippe Candeloro skating to the music of The Godfather. We thought we'd hear names like Ermanov, Candeloro, Davis, Stoico in 4 years in Nagano, but it seems that the future is now.
He's inventive, he's crazy, and a lot of fun to watch. This man might skate well enough to hold on to a medal. A solid jumper with a very conservative classic style, Alexei Ermanov sits in first place. Scott Davis is quick, strong, and has the best spins in the competition. He also has a great shot at a medal. And as far as this man's concerned, Elvis Stoico, he's probably considered the best athlete in the competition. We just may see a quad-triple combination for the first time in skating history. And if you want to know if he's looking ahead or over his shoulder, Elvis is looking no farther than himself.
That's what I'm hoping for tomorrow night, is to challenge myself and not hold back on anything. Like people said, you take out the quad combo, and I said, no, why would I? Like I said, it doesn't matter the placing, I'm still gonna do the same stuff. It's a matter of personal best, and if a gold medal is possible, hey, it's a bonus.
When we return to the Northern Lights Hall in Hamar, we'll have more of the ice dancing competition.
Vern and Scotty, thank you.